first major thing which we are doing is, so for development of terminals, as you know that Pandu is a major terminal here. There are several other projects going in the northeast region, in Manipur, Loktok, in Tripura, in Mizoram, which we have planned in future. We are also developing the Jogigopa multimodal terminal, which is under the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway. They will do the road part, railway bit is railway part, and we are doing the water terminal part.
আর এই মুহূর্তে আমার সহ উপস্থিত আছে ইনলেন্ড ওয়াটার অথরিটি অফ ইন্ডিয়ার চেয়ারম্যান সঞ্জয় বন্দ্যোপাধ্যায়। মানে স্যারক স্বাগত জানাইছো অনুষ্ঠানের মাজলে। স্যার বহুত বহুত স্বাগত হ্যাঁ আসাম মে
আর
স্পেশালি নর্থ ইস্ট মে বহুত প্রসপেক্টস হ্যাঁ ডিপার্টমেন্ট কে, তো আপসে জাননা চাহেঙ্গে কেসে আপ লোগো কা ফিউচার প্ল্যানিংস হ্যাঁ। লেকিন পহলে তো ইয়ে জাননা চাহেঙ্গে কি ইয়ে পহলি ভিজিট হ্যায় আপকা আসাম মে আর হ্যাভ ইউ বিন হিয়ার বিফোর?
আসাম মে মে আ চুকা হুম, মে গভর্নমেন্ট অফ ইন্ডিয়া মে 2010 से हूँ, तो पहले रोड ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड हाईवे से दूसरे मिनिस्ट्री से आ चुका हूँ।
यस, सो व्हाट वाज योर एक्सपीरियंसेस हियर इन असम?
एक्सेलेंट, एक्सेलेंट एरिया, गुड पीपल, थैंक यू।
ओके सर, सो पहले सर हम आपसे ये जानना चाहेंगे कि व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस एंड इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस डिपार्टमेंट, व्हाट डू यू बिलीव सर?
ये दिस इज एन अथॉरिटी कॉल्ड द इनलैंड वाटरवे अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया। इट इज अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पोर्ट शिपिंग एंड वाटरवेज।
यस,
and there are 111 national waterways, waterways declared as national waterways, in which our main thing is to develop it for water transport, both longitudinally for and across the rivers, for both cargo and passenger movement. And major works are going on in 23 to 25 waterways, because the water transport, as you know, is the cheapest mode of transport. It is cheaper than road and rail, and the logistic cost. Now the target of every country is to reduce the transportation cost, logistic cost. Ours is as high as 14% to 15%, and the world over, the best economies have brought it down to 8%. If you save this money in the transportation and logistics, then your product will become competitive in the global market. You will sell more in dollars and foreign exchange, and you will further develop your economy. So that is the main target, and whatever are the methods available and the latest technologies, we will use to develop this water transport. And for us, this Brahmaputra, Barak and other rivers of the northeast are very important. Because if you see world over, water transport had developed not with starting with thousands of kilometers, but started with some tens of kilometers, moving to hundreds and thousands.
Yes.
And that is why the products have become viable, a product which may be appear to be a bit costly, but if it is moved from Assam by waterways to Haldia and further exported, it will save cost and become competitive in global market. So that is what we are doing in the northeast. That is our plan.
And sir, especially the most important waterways here in India are basically Ganga and Brahmaputra as well. So specifically, if we ask about the Brahmaputra, what would be your future prospects and targets here to fulfill?
Brahmaputra is a mighty and godsend river for this part of the country. It has a long stretch, and historically it was being used for water transport. Over the years it stopped, longitudinal cargo stopped, though across the Brahmaputra passenger movement is there.
Yes.
And now our objective is to move the goods, whichever is available here, from the furthermost ponds, nearly Sadia of Brahmaputra, up to Dubri. This stretch in Brahmaputra and further down, we are also have a protocol and understand agreement with the government of Bangladesh for moving it across Bangladesh up to Haldia and connecting it to Ganga. So we are developing the water channel, that is the fairway. if sufficient depth is available, the water level fluctuates throughout the year. Sufficient water level is available by dredging and other means, water conservation, river training methods. So the vessels will move and over the entire stretch cross Bangladesh and go up to Haldia. So the people living in Assam along the banks, near the banks of Brahmaputra will get this mode of transport, cheaper mode of transport right up to Haldia, which is an export port. This is the gateway for our export and import. Similarly, people will be skilled around Brahmaputra and many material can come and further they can be value added on it and exported to other countries. And for this, first major thing which we are doing is the development of fairway. Then we come to the terminals. So for development of terminals, as you know that Pandu is a major terminal here. We are developing it further. It's the gateway for Guwahati area. So that terminal is being developed. We are trying to bring in a new approach road. We are also developing a ship repair facility here.
Yes.
With the help of Cochin Shipyard Limited, which can repair larger ships. We are also developing the Jogi Gopa multimodal terminal, which is under the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway. They will do the road part, railway bit is railway part, and we are doing the water terminal part. That will be also available for transportation of goods all over Brahmaputra and beyond through Bangladesh. Dhubri is another terminal which is already seen, has cargo. Goes up to Chirimari and further. We want to push cargo from there to further down up to Haldia. And several other jetties will be developed, both for cargo as well as passenger amenities in this area. Now coming to the Barak, which is a very important river, we plan to upgrade the terminals at Karimganj, Badarpur and more terminals which will be available, because cargo movement can be seen there on the Barak River into Bangladesh and across the river also. So these are the things. And there are several other projects going in the northeast region, in Manipur, Loktok in Manipur, in Tripura, in Mizoram, which we have planned in future.
So do you still think that there is a need of infrastructural development here in Assam specifically?
I think if you see even the most developed countries, there the addition of infrastructure never stops. Because infrastructure wise, there is always a need. Technology changes, infrastructure upgradation takes place. Infrastructure becomes old, it has to be renewed. And new materials, new technology comes in. So this is a continuous process and cycle, which has to develop, and final objective is to increase the efficiency of the region.
And what would be the latest mode of transportation here in Assam? Because the ships here are not as we have came across. The ships for the transportation are not up to the mark. So is there any possibility here to develop?
So for cargo movement, first for cargo movement, we want to start a scheduled service up to Assam from Haldia, and which will give a scheduled service for the merchandise to go up to Haldia. Secondly, we are planning to help the shipbuilding area, shipbuilding people in this area or nearby, to bring in more vessels in the river with the help of the business community. Similarly, for passenger movement across the river, the government of Assam has a World Bank scheme in which they are funding the engines, marine engine, as well as the life jackets. So we'll be also, yesterday we had a meeting, long meeting, and we offered to help them technically in development of cheaper marine engines. So this is the two major requirement demand of this area, which we wish and we hope we'll be able to fulfill the ambition of the people.
And this department recently has been headed by the ex-Chief Minister of Assam, Mr. Sarbanand Sonowal. So I think you have spoken to him also. So what kind of changes he wants here and what is the development he is looking
forward
to?
Yesterday he took a meeting at Pandu, and all these projects is guidelines are given by them. He has a vision for this area. He, under the Honorable Prime Minister, he has a vision for this area. He has chalked out an action plan for us, and whatever we are doing under his guidance.
Okay, and there has always been an allegation about Northeast has always been not prioritized in comparison to the other parts of the country. So how would be your plans to connect the Northeast with the other parts of the country through the waterways?
See, for us, the waterways is, wherever there are waterways, the part of the country is important for us. And as I told you earlier, Brahmaputra is a godsend river, mighty river, where we are trying to do the best. Other rivers, the Barak River and other rivers are also there. Northeast is blessed with rivers, so we want to give our maximum effort and resources to this area. This area should never feel that it's left behind. We are there, and this is the one of the most important project going in Northeast under the Inland Waterway Authority.
So this visit to Assam, can we expect something new and something?
As I told you, that new means the terminals, the marine engine, the vessels. This is something above the usual schemes which are going on.
थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर टाइम सर. मुझे आपसे बात करके बहुत अच्छा लगा और आशा करते हैं कि आपको बाद में भी हम बात करेंगे और असम के डेवलपमेंट के बारे में आपसे बहुत कुछ जानना चाहेंगे.
थैंक यू.
यह आसिल नतुन कोई नवनिजुक्त इनलैंड वाटर अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडियार नवनिजुक्त चेयरमैन संजय बंदोपाध्याय. तखे इतिम्य कैसे विभिन्न प्रानर सहित भारतक कनेक्ट करें भारतक संयुक्त करें विभागटे और अथरीटी के व्यवस्था ग्रहण कर तार समानक प्रातन मुख्यमंत्री और बर्तमान विभाग मंत्री सरबानंद सोनवालदेवे केनेधरणे गोटेई विभागटो आगबढ़ाई लै जोवार क्षेत्रत एटा नतुनत्वनार चेष्टा करिछे एई आभासटो दिबलै आमि तेखेतर होइछे आजि बार्तालाप करिछिलोँ.